Hi, I'm Alex from KiwiCo. We're always looking to science to help answer interesting questions about the world around us, like this question from Ella.
Hi Alex, what are soap's super cleaning powers?
Great question. Humans have been using soap for thousands of years to keep things squeaky clean. And that's in part because soap has the very special and super ability to mix with both oil and water. You might already know that oil and water are not friends. They just don't mix. No matter how hard you shake them together, they will always separate. That is, unless you add soap. Let's try it out. See the difference? Adding soap made it possible for the oil and water to combine. The reason this works has to do with the chemistry of soap. A molecule is a small piece inside a substance or object. Soap molecules are pretty special because they have two different ends. One end is happy to mix with water, so we call that the water-loving or hydrophilic end. Hydro means water and philic means loving. The other end really doesn't want to be in water. So we call that the water-fearing or hydrophobic end. You guessed it, phobic means fearing. The hydrophilic end of the soap grabs onto water while the hydrophobic end grabs onto oil. With the soap holding onto both, the oil gets broken up and mixed into the water. The same thing happens with other messy stuff like oily grease and fats in food, which is why soap is perfect for cleaning dirty plates and hands. To see soap's superpowers in action, we're going to do an experiment with milk. Yep, milk. And that's because milk contains both water and fat. Just like oil, the fat molecules in milk grab onto the water-fearing or hydrophobic ends of soap, which makes it the perfect liquid for our soap experiment. Normally, this experiment is done on a small scale using milk, a bowl, liquid colors, liquid dish soap, and a cotton swab. But at KiwiCo, we like to do things big. So we've scaled things up a bit. Let's get started. Our first step is a lot of milk. To avoid waste, we're using recently expired milk, so it's not good for drinking, but it's perfect for our experiment. Our second step is to drop in some liquid colors. See how the liquid colors are just floating on top of the milk? That's because the liquid color is made of water and it isn't able to easily mix with the oily fats in the milk. Now's the fun part. Let's use our giant cotton swab to put some soap in the middle of the pool and see what happens. The colors spread and swirl around and make some really cool patterns. These explosions are showing soap's special ability to clean. When the soap touches the milk, it is attracted to the fat, so it spreads out to grab as many fat molecules as it can. The moving and mixing of the fat and soap molecules creates these colorful explosions. Soap's super abilities to mix with both oil and water make it the perfect thing to help us wash our hands, dishes, and clothes. When you use soap to wash your hands, the oil-loving or hydrophobic ends grab onto the oils, grease, or fat from foods and other dirty things. When you rinse, the water-loving or hydrophilic ends follow the water down the drain, taking the bad stuff with it. So there's your answer. Soap indeed has superpowers, and luckily for us, we have lots of it to keep us clean. Thanks for experimenting with me. Try making your own rainbow milk swirl at home and ask a grown-up to share a video or photo of your colorful explosions on Instagram. And make sure to tag @KiwiCo_Inc.